I'm Soledad O'Brien. Welcome to Matter of Fact. You probably know about the battle in South Carolina between Republican Congressman Lindsey Graham and his Democratic challenger, Jamie Harrison. According to recent polls, Harrison, who was once considered a long shot, is in a dead heat with Graham. But there's another fight in South Carolina, a turf war you might not have heard of, a battle for land and legacy. In just a few days, hundreds of properties in one county will be auctioned off. Dozens of those properties belong to the Gullah Geechee people, descendants of slaves who still live on the Sea Islands, which stretch from northern Florida to North Carolina. Most of the land was bought by or given to freed slaves after the Civil War and has been passed down for generations. As correspondent Jessica Gomez tells us, some say during the middle of a pandemic, the tax sale should be delayed.
Along the shores of St. Helena Island and surrounding the marshes of South Carolina's Lowcountry are whispers of the past, the stories of those who've lived here for generations.
My grandmother, she loved trees.
Cynthia Welch trying to keep her grandmother's yard and legacy alive. Mary Brown was the granddaughter of freed slaves who bought their home in the late 1800s.
They worked hard to own this land, to get this and to pass it on. And on her dying breath, she begged us, you know, please don't sell it.
Welch, who was furloughed from her job at a hotel because of COVID-19, couldn't catch up on past due property taxes and was notified this summer her home would go to auction.
And I was lived in fear every single day that this house could be taken away.
Welch, one of hundreds of delinquent landowners in Beaufort County, whose property is scheduled to go to next week's annual tax sale.
After the auction, that delinquent property owner has 1 year to pay back the highest bidder with interest. If they can't afford it, they lose their property for good.
Under mounting pressure to delay the auction until next spring, County Treasurer Maria Wall says unless state law is changed, the county would also be forced to collect this and next year's taxes as well.
So that delay of the tax sale comes in some cases, at a very steep cost to the property owner.
We met Teresa White, head of the nonprofit, the Pan-African Family Empowerment Network, at the historic Penn Center. It was one of the first schools for freed West African slaves. The Gullah Geechee, as they're still known, went on to own much of the coastal land in Beaufort County.
Some of these families are living on land that their families have owned since the 1860s. They have never lived anywhere else.
An effort now to keep that land in the hands of the Gullah people. While retaining much of their culture here, they're rapidly losing their property. Much of it passed down from generation to generation, often with no legal deed, making it complicated and costly for heirs to develop and vulnerable to outside investors.
And the next thing you know, there's a big, fabulous resort, a subdivision, with a gate around it.
Just to the south on Hilton Head Island, once mostly Gullah owned, there are now multi-million dollar homes and resorts. A stark contrast to nearby historic Gullah neighborhoods. For many here, the property taxes have become unaffordable, and the pandemic making things worse.
Gullah is an opportunity for us to have, you know, food for the soul.
Hilton Head restaurant owner Tim Singleton is back in business after shutting his doors for 3 months. Once donating to help save other Gullah land, he's now the one delinquent on two other properties.
Now I got a taste of what people go through, whether it's the stress and anxiety of losing your home or losing your property.
The conversation we're having about property taxes.
Republican State Senator Tom Davis represents much of Beaufort County. Late last month, he authored a bill that was passed in the state legislature, giving those whose properties were auctioned off last year a 12-month extension to save them.
The idea there is, Jess, is to give these families time to recover from what COVID-19 may have inflicted upon them in terms of economic status.
Why the decision not to delay the October 2020 auction, though?
You've got, you know, county and local governments that depend on tax revenues, and that would be extraordinarily disruptive.
I am delighted to be able to present you this check
leaving Teresa White and her nonprofit scraping together last-minute donations to save as much land as they can.
I'm just ecstatic right now because I was worried so much till I was just getting sick because I didn't know how I was going to pay for this.
And I always say there's always an angel somewhere.
Cynthia Welch receiving the same relief with just days to go, saving her grandmother's legacy for now.
I think she said, telling me, "What, good job, Cynthia. You kept the house. Good job."
In Beaufort County, South Carolina, for Matter of Fact, I'm Jessica Gomez.
The tax sale moves forward on Monday. There are growing calls to cap property taxes on historic Gullah Geechee land. Senator Davis says that's something he's going to look into when the legislative session resumes come January.